Listen, Andy Ruiz, being his former trainer, you're always going to be tied to him. I want to pull up this video here. I just want to watch it and let me know what you see. And
somebody showed it to me.
You see?
I heard
he lifted up his shirt. He showed a little bit of abs there. What do you make of his update or what?
Congratulations.
Yeah.
You should have thought about that on the rematch when he fought Tyson. When he was a world champion. You know, it's never too late. It's never too late.
Those are the words of Manny Robles after he was asked about his feelings of the new transformation of Andy Ruiz, the Destroyer, the former unified champion, Ruiz. And he said he should have been doing that in the rematching. He said Tyson Fury, but he meant Anthony Joshua. But he should have been doing that when he fought Anthony Joshua. Now it's too late. You know? Let's see what else Manny says.
I mean, now he lost something precious, which was being a heavyweight champion of the world. I tried to convince him, but he was, you know, Mike's. Unfortunately, his man was somewhere else. Now apparently, you know, the situation is different, you know, and I wish him nothing but the best, man. I don't hate on him. I wish him. Hopefully, he'll become a world champion again. This ain't about me. This is about them, man. It's about the fighter.
So he goes on. He says he missed something precious. You know, it's funny because Manny Robles was that guy in that position, probably the only guy in that position that can say what he says. And a lot of people might look at it as hating. A lot of people, you know, over-criticizing Andy Ruiz, but you have to understand the position that Manny Robles was in, okay? Yeah, he got him there, okay? He took him to that championship, okay? So he's more significant. Up to this date, the person that was more impactful for Andy Ruiz, training-wise, was Manny Robles, okay? Eddie Reynoso, he's training him now. And I'm pretty sure he's going to get credit because I'm pretty sure that Andy Ruiz will do well. You know, that's my expectations of him, especially because he knows what's expected of him being there with Canelo and Frank Sanchez and Ryan Garcia. Those guys are all working together. So it's expected of him. With Manny Robles got him to that part in his career, but a lot of that was due to self-driven spirit. Okay, Andy Ruiz had that at that time. Now, he lost it all because of success, I feel. Success, comfort, you know, being in an unfamiliar experimental position. It was all something he's never been in. And I think all that deterred him tremendously. You know, and back to Manny, and he said, hey, I tried to get this guy to do what I needed him to do, but he wasn't doing it. His mind was somewhere else. Hopefully he can do it again. And I see a little bitterness there. Do I call it hating? No, because the bitterness, I don't think it comes from a negative part from Manny Robles. It comes from a disappointment in from Manny Robles to his former a pupil. Because he could have done that then. So looking at it, if you're Manny Robles, and you're looking at Andy Ruiz now doing the shit he's supposed to do, what else could you say? What else could you really say to anybody if you were in that position? Sure, he could have chose to say, well, I wish him well, but no. It's a real and natural response too. Because it ain't like, oh, I wish him the best, he looks great, this, that, and the other. That's the politician answer. Okay, that's the politician answer. Oh, he looks great. I wish him well. He looks really good. He looks very fast and quick now. And I wish him the very best. Sure, you could say that, but only saying that, would that be authentic? Would that be authentic? Would that be real? Okay? What he said, what Manny said was real. He should have done that shit when he was with me. He could have, because it just tells you, if his mind was in the right place, he could have done that with Manny Robles. So in other words, he didn't have to change trainers at all. It all lied within. Within Andy. And here and here. It all lied within. So for whatever reason, maybe he doesn't have that money like he used to. Maybe he spent a lot of it. Maybe it's something that he has to prove. Maybe he lost everything and the feeling of losing everything had him. But Manny, what Manny was ultimately saying, if you read between the lines, there was no reason for him to leave Manny Robles. He could have done that while he was with Manny Robles. So Andy getting his father, which is his manager, to fire Manny Robles was unnecessary. It was. You know what I mean? Because it just shows you that, hey, he could have took that same energy and did that with that same trainer. That's what Manny's saying. If that makes sense. That's exactly what Manny's saying. You know, but no, like he said, no, I wish him the best. But he missed the plot when he was with me. And then the only thing that you could really go on, and the only experiences I had with Andy, is when I got him the title. I was there when he achieved the title. But the thing is, defending the title. And that's something that he was incapable of doing at the time. You know, so Manny really unapologetically broke down his feelings about Andy Ruiz in a nice way. I mean, it wasn't hating. It wasn't hating again. But you can still tell a little bitterness when it came for him seeing what Andy's doing right now and wishing that when he was once with him. And like Manny said, it's not about me. It's about the fighter. The only problem is when the fighter comes up short, it's always the trainer's a job damn near, right? Unwanted job to be thrown under the bus to take the blame for the loss. Like this, you know, should have happened and you should have done this, you should have done that, you know, but then the fighter, it brings slack off the fighter and less blame on the fighter than the trainer. To blame it on the trainer. Okay, so Manny, you know, you see, he laughed with that, but he was like, well, hell, he could have been doing that with me. That's something that is the ideal, realistic response. You know, and I'm all for it. I think that Manny didn't come off hating or anything like that. I just think that he knows what the man can do because he saw the man do it. Okay, he saw him train his ass off. He seen him go from one fight and went right back into training and then train for Joshua, then beating Joshua, and then seeing him lose it all and seeing how he went from here all the way back down here. He saw that. He saw that shit. And he saw the change. He saw the change due to success. So yes, it's a natural response, a realistic response from Manny Robles. You guys tell me what you think about Manny Robles' response to Andy Ruiz's weight loss and body transformation. Of course, please subscribe. And you guys been Counterpunch. Peace.